This is your Hispanic Latino Student Association Executive Board.
Bienvenidos at Terry Concert Hall, and thank you so much for attending Jacksonville University's second annual Hispanic Heritage Concert and Celebration.
Please take this time to silence your cell phones, and please do not use flash photography as it may distract the performers.
This concert includes opportunities for audience participation. While we want to get you up and moving, please make sure you are doing so safely.
Enjoy the show! Happy Hispanic Heritage Month!
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. popular dances such as the tango, rumba, mambo, and the cha-cha-cha. Bossa Nova was a marriage of American jazz and the samba rhythm from Brazil, and based on musical concepts not related to dance styles. The roots of Bossa Nova happened in Los Angeles in about 1953. It didn't have a huge impact in the United States, but a number of young musicians from Brazil coveted the style. One of these young Brazilians was Antonio Carlos Jobim. It was Jobim, along with and please forgive me, my Brazilian Portuguese is really awful, Gilberto, who became the key figure of Bossa Nova. During a 1961 tour, guitarist Charlie Bird heard the music in Brazil. He went into the studio in 62 and recorded an album called Jazz Samba, which became a huge hit in the United States. It launched the Bossa Nova craze in this country and opened the door for Jobim, Gilberto, and his wife, Astrid Gilberto, to introduce Bossa Nova to the world. The music has been largely defined by the compositions of Jobim, who left a legacy of over 300 songs, including One Note Samba, The Wave, and The Girl from Ipanema, which was a worldwide hit for Jobim and his singing wife, Astrid Gilberto. Bossa Nova was so popular in the early 60s that almost every jazz artist made a Bossa Nova album, or at the very least, recorded a Bossa Nova tune. The Rivertones are honored to perform The Girl from Ipanema in memory of Astrid Gilberto, who died just this past June.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. 11, 12, 13, 14,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9,
10,
11,
12,
13, 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema. 2023, the world lost one of its most influential musical voices. Astrid Gilberto is a household name. She's an iconic figure in Hispanic culture and music, celebrated for her enchanting voice and pivotal role in popularizing bossa nova, a genre that became a global sensation in the 1960s. Astrid's journey into the world of music was somewhat unexpected. While living in the United States, she was married to the legendary Brazilian guitarist João Gilberto. In 1963, during the recording of the album Getz Sas Gilberto, which featured the likes of Stan Getz and Antonio Carlos Jobim, a serendipitous moment changed her life forever. When Astrid was asked to sing the English lyrics to the song, The Girl from Ipanema, the outcome was nothing short of magical. The Girl from Ipanema became an instant classic and a massive hit, reaching the top of the Billboard Hot 100 charts in the United States. This song not only launched Astrid's career, but also played a pivotal role in introducing bossa nova to the international stage. Astrid's light, soothing voice blended seamlessly with the laid-back rhythms and intricate harmonies of bossa nova, creating a sensation that would define an era.
Astrid Gilberto served as a global ambassador for bossa nova, a genre deeply rooted in Brazilian culture. Through her music, she brought the sounds and rhythms of Brazil to audiences worldwide, helping to popularize Brazilian music and culture on an unprecedented scale. Astrid's ability to sing in both Portuguese and English allowed her to bridge the gap between Brazilian and American audiences. Her English language recordings introduced bossa nova to a broader international audience, fostering cross-cultural appreciation. Her collaboration with influential musicians such as Stan Getz, João Gilberto, and Antonio Carlos Jobim created a fusion of musical talents that enriched the world of Latin jazz and bossa nova, leaving an indelible mark.
You still get nervous now when you appear before an audience?
Yeah.
Are you scared now?
I'm scared, yeah, very much. But it goes away after the show.
Astrid's contribution to Hispanic culture and music extends to inspiring generations of aspiring artists. Her unique vocal style and storytelling through music have left a lasting legacy, influencing artists across genres. Astrid Gilberto's significance in Hispanic culture and music cannot be overstated. Her enchanting voice and role in popularizing bossa nova transcended borders and languages, making her an enduring symbol of the rich musical heritage of Brazil and Latin America. Her legacy lives on in the hearts of music lovers around the world, and her contribution on a global scale is, put simply, undeniable.
delicadeza, una mano dura, otra en la cabeza. A mí me gusta ver su delicadeza, una mano en la cintura, otra en la cabeza. Cuando llega a baile, llama la atención, viene a la ciudad. Ella se lo luchó, baila con su estilo, como un tiburí. Eso es que yo tío, y esa negra tiene swing. ¡Eso! ¡Ay!
Bye.